Every night, when I get tired, I would ask myself, why am I not going to bed? Sunday, I had to finish my homework. Monday, I came home after school, took a nap, went to Kensian practice, and I had to finish my homework again. Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, it's all the same. My life is a 24-hour tape on repeat. Every day, I wake up with the same problems, I confront the same problems, and I go to bed with the same problems. Everything stays the same, nothing changes. But life shouldn't be like this. Life should be exciting. Life should be full of purpose. Life should be full of change. So where did my life go? Well, I already checked the school's ups and downs, and I didn't find it there. I thought I lost life within myself. I started doing projects that were not homework. I started building helicopters for Science Olympia. I started writing my own blog. I started writing this speech. What I found was, homework wasn't the problem that led to me losing life. I was the problem. I was overwhelmed by the weight of uncertainty. When I was building my helicopter, I kept thinking about how long it would fly on the actual competition, and if I would get a medal to put on my collagen. I kept thinking about how many more hours I would need to spend to finish my helicopter, and if the result would be worth the effort. When I was running my blog, I started with an idea, but then I started to doubt myself. I wondered if my idea was too personal, too negative, or too boring. Doubt impeded my progress. When I was writing the speech, I went through 5 revisions before arriving at this version. Doubt and uncertainty made me walk in a circle. I wasn't moving forward. The future is scary because we are not in control. No matter what we do, no matter how much we analyze the situation, there will always be risks. We can try our best, but our efforts may still end up in vain. We may still not achieve the things we want to achieve, and we may disappoint ourselves. We may disappoint others. I didn't want to deal with this, but I had to. In my 8th grade year, I started an annual challenge, Google Science Fair. It was an online science fair where you make a website about your science fair project, and you submit it. After you submit it, you wait a few months to hear back from Google. You either get selected as a finalist, or you don't get selected. My first year, I wanted to make this air pollution filter that was more science fiction than reality. In the end, I ended up procrastinating until the last weekend, and I pulled together a presentation that was not my best work. Later in that year, I got my first certificate of participation. The first certificate ignited a spark in me. It told me that I didn't achieve my goal, but I took this setback as a challenge. Next year, I will try harder, I will become better, and I will be a finalist no matter what. The second year, I went all out. I created a battery from dirt. So I went to a nearby swamp and dug up dirt and put wires in between to light up a light bulb. And along with my project, I made websites, pictures, videos. I did my best. And later that year, I got my second certificate of participation. I was surprised. I felt defeated. I spent all this effort this year to only get the same certificate I got last year, but with a different color. The second certificate taught me resilience. Yes, I tried my best, but maybe I could have done better. I could have tried harder. So, at the end of the day, the result was very clear. I did not become a finalist. I did not achieve my goal, and no matter the odds, I had to try it again. The third year was the best year. I made something science fiction. I made a website that can read your brainwaves. I will not go into the details, but I spent my whole winter break, my weekends, my spring break working on this project, and I developed the technology, I made the website, the pictures, the videos, and everything that went along with it, and I changed the odds. I changed my fate. Later that year, I got my third certificate of participation. The third certificate taught me hope. It brought me more pain than ever before, because I tried my best and yet once again I still failed. But giving up never flashed once across my head. 3 years were long enough to build a personal growth, and having tried so hard, there was no turning back. Uncertainty no longer scared me. In fact, uncertainty became a comfort. When I stayed up working late at night, I would entertain the idea of success. And uncertainty told me that no matter how great the odds were against me, I could be the one single exception. Uncertainty can be daunting, but when we point it in the other direction, when we believe in our potentials, uncertainty becomes a solace. Uncertainty becomes hope. Uncertainty becomes possibility. Taking a step back out of my life and looking at the world around me, I see that uncertainty is powerful. I watched interviews with North Korean defectors on YouTube, and they risked their lives crossing the river into China and making their way into South Korea. All along the way, they faced tremendous difficulties. If they get caught in China, they will get deported and sent to jail. If they arrive in South Korea, they still face the hardships of assimilation. But nevertheless, they still put their life on the line for freedom, because there is that chance of success. And around the world, there are people who walk miles to get clean water, and there are people who take on demanding jobs to feed their families. They don't stop, they keep going. Uncertainty tells us that despite our circumstances, we are not bound to a situation. We can chase after our dreams. No one can dissuade us, because no one knows what the future holds. No one can deny or reject a possibility. This is why every idea, every attempt has potential. I can believe in an idea that the whole world does not, and uncertainty gives me a chance to disprove the world. A while ago, someone asked me, what is my purpose in life? I described this picture. We are in front of Mount Everest. The odds are against us, but we don't give up. We climb, we struggle, we fall, we get hurt, but tomorrow we grow stronger and we climb further. The future has infinite possibilities, and if we never try, we never know. Thank you.